the time that a crystal was precise and stable enough for frequency determination is a thing of the past since the digital modes. On the HF bands, there are enough references to determine the frequency. On higher frequencies, that is more difficult. Then clocking to GPS satellites is very suitable and easy to realize. The following method was not invented by me. In fact, the entire circuit consists of only three ready-made circuit boards. Only a breakout board with the SI5351A PLL, an Arduino and a GPS receiver. For the 5V DC, the voltage regulator in the Arduino is sufficient for the PLL board and the display. For the GPS module, I'm not sure. I added a 78L05 voltage regulator. Possibly connect a small display, but that is not even necessary. A single LED could also show if the frequency is locked. Everything can be purchased cheaply. The Arduino, the SI5351 and F2L the display are connected to each other as usual with SDA and SCL. The GPS receiver must be a model with PPS output, which means that when it receives satellites, a pulse is given every second. Then the clever circuit. Output clock 0 of the SI5351 is programmed to 2.5 MHz and routed to the Arduino's frequency counter input port, in this case pin D5. The 1 pulse per second output from the GPS receiver is routed to the Arduino's interrupt 0 input port, in this case pin D2. It acts as a counter gate. The Arduino counts the 2.5 MHz input over a 40 second gate time, resulting in a 100 MHz total count. This count is used to recalculate the 25 MHz clock frequency of the PLL board. Total system uncertainty, including calculation resolution limitations and clock drift during counter gate time, is better than 1 part in 10 million. In the sketch, the wanted frequency comes from clock 1 of the breakout board. As highest frequency, I tried the half in the 70 cm band, so above 200 MHz, without any problem. As demonstrated in this video, the SI5351 generates a lot of harmonics, so at higher frequencies the specific harmonic could be used. Accuracy will still be very good. Demonstration. So this is all what is needed. The PLL board, the Arduino and the GPS board, and if you like, also a display. I found out that, strange enough, you need to change the frequency on two places of in the sketch. One is what it shows on the display. The other is what is used to generate the frequency. And this is shown on the display, and I will reset it that you can see what happens when it starts up. And I only reset the Arduino, and the GPS PCB can take some time before it receives satellites. In this case it receives 10 satellites, but it can take a few minutes before satellites are received. And this is the frequency that I have keyed in the sketch. In the serial monitor could be seen that there is a correction of 229.4 Hz, and it also displays my latitude and longitude, and it says that the GPSDO is not locked at this moment. And then it starts to oscillate, to deliver a signal, it takes some time before you get the signal. And it still says it is not locked. And after 40 seconds, you have another correction, in this case 0.2 Hz, and then it says it is locked. And when we go back to the display, there's here the at shown that it is locked, but also the LED lights up now. So if you don't have a display or use a display, then you can use the LED. But then you don't know how many satellites you receive and you don't know what time it is. Yes. So that's the story. In this case, I used it with my receiver on the 70 centimeter band. Now you see that it has a bit small change, and you see immediately a small jump here. But it is only 1.2 Hz, and it is likely because it is completely open here. If I blow to the PC board with the PLL, you see already a lot of drift. So it is always good to have it all shielded and temperature stable. If you like this kind of experiments, please subscribe, give a thumb, and if you have questions, I will see it below in the comments. Next step is to make the frequency change possible with the rotary encoder, so that I don't have to use to change the sketch every time. Bye.